تفضل.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome all of you, wherever you are. And welcome you again with this lecture, the 11th, from the explanation of Surah An-Nahl. We start with Allah Azza wa Jal saying, with Satan, after seeking his refuge from the shaitan regime, eat what he had sustained to you, good sustenance, and be grateful for the bounty of Allah if you are worshiping him. Allah Almighty is ordering his believers what he ordered his messengers to eat from the halal sources, and to be grateful to it and to thank him for it, because he's the one who sustains, who gives. He's the one who gives. We deserve the worship, no partners with him. In the hadith of Abi Huraira, the Prophet ﷺ says,
فقال تعالى يا أيها الرسل كلوا من الطيبات واعملوا صالحا، وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا.
Allah also said, eat from the goodness of what we have given you. And then he mentioned the person that he prolonged the traveling. He raised his head to the skies and he said, oh Allah, and he'll eat from permissible sources, and he'll eat, dress from something and accepted, and his sustenance is from something that Allah forbids. Allah has forbidden you the pigs, the dead, and he mentioned a couple of things, and whomever done that not want to do it, he is forced into it, not the want to go back to it. Allah is most forgiving. Allah forbidden whatever is harmful to people in their religion and their life. And also in some other verse, Allah had detailed more. And whatever is given for someone beside Allah. So whomever had to, with no wanted to go back, Allah is most forgiven. The pig. The meat covers everything. The Prophet ﷺ says, whomever played the Nardashir, as if he have put his hand in the fat of the pig, and this is for touch. Can you imagine for eating it and enjoying it? That shows that it's not only the meat, it's all bones, meat, everything that has to do with the pig. In the other narration, the Prophet said that Allah forbid to sell the liquor, the dead, the pig, and the idols. Then it was asked, oh Prophet of Allah, can you see the fat? You're going to be able to use it for the ships, and you have other benefits. He said, no, it is forbidden. So they mentioned few benefits for the fat of the pig. He said, no, it is forbidden. So this will take us about the dead, and we live in the American society when we talk about the slaughtering and the slaughtering of this country. There is a very indication of what is allowed with the time. And we have mentioned before, and I'm going to repeat it again, and I stress on it, that the Assembly of Muslim Jurist Association, they have a conference for what is allowed, what is forbidden from the food and medicine outside Muslim countries. And they finish about the slaughtering with some of the issues that control this. We'll take it very quickly. The decision says that it has to be from a Muslim or a people of the book, Christian or Jews, and it will be on enjoyment unless proven otherwise. And the people of the book, to belong to Judaism or Christianity, because of the addressing of the Quran to them that in that way. And this controls the United States because this is the majority of the people because they belong to Christianity. Unless it is known, a certain slaughterhouse that whomever are in control is different than that. The slaughtering will not be accepted from those people who do not have a religion. From non-Muslims.
لا تشترط تسمية أهل الكتاب على ذبائحهم على الراجح عند جمهور أهل العلم فقد أحل الله ذبائحهم وقد علم أن أغلبهم لا يحبون.
But they should not say something else beside Allah. They don't slaughter for something else beside Allah. So anyone who have the Islamic characteristics, no matter what disobedience he is, or he have innovation, but where he declares something that forbid him from being a Muslim, then his slaughtering is not allowed. And the naming to say in the name of Allah and to flow the blood, and if an animal run, if you hit him with anyway with the mention of Allah's name, it is okay. The slaughtering is the preferred way of cows and birds and lambs and so on. And it will be in the neck, and it's best when it's the the two veins. And it has to be with something is what is preferred is to slaughter from the vein to the vein and to have the blood come out. And the aqwar, which is when you are hunting on the things that you cannot reach or something that run away from in any part of his body where the blood comes out. And also they say you cannot use the bullet because it does cause a problem for the animal, and not to use also electrocution. Because the animal, when he dies, if he died before the slaughtering, it is dead and you cannot eat it. And whatever you get before it's dead, then it is permissible. The hand slaughtering is much harder and it is much better.
يكره تعمل إبادة الرأس عند التركية قبل زهوق الروح بالكلية لما في ذلك من زيادة تعذيب للحيوان لغير ضرورة لكن لا يحرم لا يحرم أكل الذبيحة. يتورع عن تناول لحوم الأبقار والأغنام المذبوحة في مذابح الولايات المتحدة.
You prefer it's not forbidden, but it is garden not to eat the cows. It's because the number of the dead are higher than normal, and plus of the way that is slaughtered differently. But the chicken or the poultry, it is allowed. Because the process goes, does not die. That is not even mentioned. And the Muslims who live outside Islam, Muslim countries, they need to have the institutions that provide the halal sources. I consider this word as a continuation to the masjid rule, and you need to be careful what the Sharia has stressed from. You have to be kind to the animals before you slaughter it, and after it, and after it. So you don't sharpen the knife in front of the animal, nor you slaughter the animal in front of the other one. And you don't slaughter him with something not sharp, and you do not make it harder. You cut part of it, nor will it be slaughtered or put in hot water, except after it's certain that it's dead.
في الرقابة الجادة على هذه المجازر ودفع شهادات الاعتماد الشرعي عند الوفاء بشروط التجهيز الشرعي.
The restaurants of non-Muslims like the Chinese or Indian, they have the same rule of the rest of the restaurant, because the source of the meat is the same. Unless you know a certain restaurant that they have their own slaughtering, then you cannot eat from their place because they are not people of the book. So we continue. So don't say to whatever your tongue describes lies. This is permissible. This is not permissible to claim falsehood on Allah. Those who claim falsehood on Allah, they will not be successful. Allah don't want us to be acting like the non-believers who made permissible what they wish, and they made others non-permissible, just like they did before. Different types of animals they have allowed and forbid with themselves. Allah said, don't claim to what your tongue claim as falsehood. This is permissible, this is non-permissible. So you could have falsehood on Allah. Those who do it will not be successful. Also, anyone who did an innovation and have no backing or allowed something Allah forbid, just because of following the desires, those who claim falsehood will not be successful. To make fatwa or verdict, it is to say something from Allah. They are silent on behalf of Allah. From the big sins, to claim to Allah what he does not know. Allah forbid what is evil, what is exposed, what is hidden, and to have partners with Allah that did not put partner authority, and to claim on Allah what you don't know. That's why the previous generations, they will not come close to make a verdict and throw it to somebody else. Fear for themselves and to save their religion. Ibn Malik said, nothing more problematic for me when somebody asks me about halal or haram.
ولقد أدركت أهل العلم والفقه في بلدنا وإن أحدهم إذا سئل عن مسألة كأن الموت أشرف.
And when someone is asked about something, he feel like he is dragged to death. And I see people nowadays, they're anxious to talk about anything that they don't know. And Umar Khattab, and Ali, and Al-Qamah, the best of the companions. The matters will come to them, and they are the best of generations that the Prophet ﷺ was sent among them. They used to gather the companions of the Prophet ﷺ and ask. And our people nowadays, they wanted to just have fatwa. And our forefathers will stay away from it. Abd al-Rahman ibn Layla, he says, I met 120 of the Ansar in Masjid. None of them will make a verdict, except that he wishes his brother will take it in his behalf. No one talk about the Prophet. He wished that somebody else did it. It's a small enjoyment. This life is nothing but a small enjoyment. It will vanish. And they have a great punishment in the hereafter. Those who claim this is permissible, this is allowed, they claim falsehood on Allah. They are getting small enjoyment in this life, but they have a great punishment in the hereafter. Like I said, we'll make them enjoy a little bit, and then we get them to a great punishment. Those who claim falsehood on Allah, they will not succeed. They get small benefit in this life, and then they come back to us in the day after, and they will give him that great punishment because of what they did. And this life, nothing except a small enjoyment. And the hereafter is better for those who fear, don't you know? And nothing you were given, it is from this life and its garments. And what Allah has, it is better and everlasting. Don't you understand? Say the enjoyment of this life is little, and the hereafter is better for those who are patient, and they are happy with this life. And this life, nothing in the hereafter except a small enjoyment. Did they accept this life from the hereafter? The enjoyment of the here in this life, nothing compared to the hereafter. But you prefer this life, and the hereafter is better for you and more lasting. By Allah, if a person lives in his life thousands of years, controlling his destiny, enjoyment everything he wants, enjoyment every bounty of his time, he don't get any illness, not even once. And I got no stress. All of this will nothing compared to the hereafter. It's not even enough for the first night in his grave.
إياك أعني يا ابن آدم فاستمع ودع الركون إلى الحياة فتنتفع لو كان عمرك ألف حول كامل لم تذهب الأيام حتى تنقطع يا أيها المرء المضيع دينه إحراز دينك خير شيء تصطنع فامهد لنفسك صالحا تجزى به وانظر لنفسك أي أمر تتبع
The Sheikh Zirsatan of poetry about that the hereafter is everlasting and this life is nothing. And it's trying to remind you to remember the time of death and cry on some sins that already passed. They're not equal, those who built for the hereafter and those who did not care. Those who did not care will be regretful. And then Allah said, and on the Jews we have forbidden what we told you before, was not doing them wrong, but they were doing themselves wrong. Meaning Allah has forbidden on them the same thing, what is forbidden on you. And then Allah said, we made forbidden what we told you before. That's because of what they did wrong. Allah had mentioned in another ayah, in Surah Al-An'am, on those who, the Jews, we have forbidden everything with a nail, and from the lambs and cows, we forbid the fat, except for that is mixed with the meat or with the bones, because of what they did wrong. And then Allah has opened for us, Allah completed the goodness and allowed it, and allowed the forbidden things at the time of necessity, because Allah wants to give ease, don't want the hardship. And would not do them wrong, but they were doing themselves wrong. It's like Allah saying, with an aggression from those who became Jews, we forbidden things that were permitted for them. And because they are staying in the path of Allah, keeping people away from the path of Allah and Allah, and eating people's money falsely. And we have prepared for those who disbelieve among them a great punishment. Then your Lord, who did wrong ignorantly, and they repented after that, and they corrected Allah after that, is most forgiving. Every person who disobeyed Allah, he has disobeyed Allah ignorantly, either by not knowing that this is wrong, or not knowing who is disobeying. Allah is telling us, out of greatness is bounty from Him, for those who disobeyed, that whomever repented, Allah has forbidden him, forgive him. And those who did wrong, anybody who disobeyed Allah, he is ignorant. And everybody who repented before death, Allah will forgive him. So they stopped what they did from the sins, and they rushed to obedience and to good deeds. Allah, after that, after this mistake, most forgiven. Nothing is greater than putting partners with Allah. Allah don't even allow that without forgiving, if you forgive him. And the Shaykh is reciting poetry about how Allah's great forgiveness is greater than any sin.
إن الله قال عن أصحاب الأخدود الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات
وخلفوا الأخدود
وأحرقوهم بالنار. قال جل من قائل إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين
Allah said those who tortured the believers and did not repent, they have the torment of Jahannam. In the Hadith, a man killed 99 souls. And then he went to ask, and he found a priest. He said, do I have a repentance? He said, no. So he made him the 100 souls. Then he kept asking, do I have a repentance? So man told him, go to this village. So he died in between. So he tilted his chest toward it. So the angels of death, they disputed. The mercy ones want to take him, and the punishment want to take him. Allah said, see the distance between them. If he's closer to the good one, then he is among the people of goodness. And Allah told the land to be longer one side and shorter the other, and it was one arm span less. And then another hadith, he went to another man, he said, as for repentance, he said, after 99 soul you kill, so he got his son and he killed him, so he became 100. Then he got the repentance, so he knew about the most knowledgeable people, so he was given to a man, he said, I killed 100 soul, do I have repentance? So he told, be careful, and who will stop you between you and repentance? Go from this bad city you're in to the good city, so and so, and worship Allah there. So he went to that village. Then he died in between. So the angels of mercy and the angels of punishment, they disputed. So Iblis said, I'm more proud for him. He did not disobey me 1 hour. So the angel of mercy, they said, he went repenting. Allah, with his bounty, forgave him. And the angels of mercy took his soul to Allah. Oh Allah, make our end the best. Subhanakallah, bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. The Shaykh is making the dua that Allah will have mercy on us. Ameen. 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 Subhanaka Allahumma shana lak safratu wa lak. Ameen. 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 Ameen.